So here we have the Avid Carp HQ Dual Layer Brolly System. As you can expect, it features extremely hard-wearing, mega waterproof 20K hydrostatic material. This all came about off the back of the success of the HQ Dual Layer Bivvies. Massive benefits with that, no faffing around with overwraps, increased internal heat, mega comfy, can cover all bases. It's a real comprehensive piece of kit. Right then guys, what we're going to do is we're going to take you for a look around and show you all of the key features. Starting at the front of the brolly, we'll start with the real nice Avid Carp camo mesh. It's real nice and small, that, so you can rest assured no creepy crawlies or mosquitoes are going to get in there and give you any bother. These can all be covered, just simply unclip the buckles and zip them in. If you've got particularly adverse weather, driving rain, big winds, or if it's particularly cold, they can be covered just to make you a little bit more comfortable. As you'd expect, the brolly's got two rod straps on the front, so your rods aren't going to slide or damage themselves. On the front of the brolly here, we've got a rain gutter, so all the rain will wash down there. It won't be falling over the front. It'll keep you nice and dry. Again, we've incorporated a peak that again creates another gutter to keep the water runoff. The brolly's got two big storm poles on the front. That makes it mega stable, even in big winds. The six pegging points again, so you can get these nice and taut and tight and looking nice. The door itself can be zipped to have letterbox style or conventionally rolled up, whichever is your preference. And lastly, the whole thing can be zipped off. So if you prefer fishing mobile, you don't need the front particularly, you can take it off and just have a lightweight brolly setup. Moving around to the back of the brolly now, it becomes very evident that the brolly is flat backed. What we've done, a pet hate for many, is that they don't want the hassle of having to carry a big bivvy round, but they want increased space in their brolly systems. So what we've done, we've removed one of the spokes, and what that's done is massively improved the internal room. As you can see, it's flat backed. You can get your bed and all your kit right up the back of your brolly without actually having a bigger shelter. The bell cap itself, that's all water sealed. You can rest assured knowing you're never ever going to get wet sat in this. The vent system at the back, two nice big zips and toggles. You can roll the outer of the brolly back to reveal some more camo mesh. Again, if you're fearful of the nasties, the bugs, the creepy crawlies, that will keep them at bay. If you crave yet more airflow, that can be zipped further to the inner capsule. That will further increase the airflow and cool you down when you're in there. Now, something that's really unique to this, the inner capsule itself can be zipped back to take you right to the center of the brolly. So if you're away in France or it's particularly hot and you want more airflow, you get a nice breeze through there and it'll keep you nice and cool and comfortable. Right, we'll take you for a little look around the inside of the brolly now. So here we are in situ in the brolly. We'll start with the dual layer. As you can see, it doesn't compromise the internal room at all, while still remaining the small gap to reduce your condensation. It's just toggled in along the inside of the brolly, so when packing it away, you haven't got to worry about it. It just folds away with the rest of the system. Moving on to the storm poles, there's two internal storm poles. These really help to stiffen the brolly up and make it extra stable in those windy conditions. As you're seeing here now, we've got a standard system. There's plenty of room for all your bits and pieces, your cookware and what have you. And lastly, today it's pretty muddy out, so we've got the heavy duty ground sheet, but it goes without saying that can be incorporated or not used with the brolly system. So here we have the brolly in its stripped down state. We've removed the front, the ground sheet, and we've also dropped the zips on the back. So whether you're a long session angler, a short session angler, whether you're fishing the summer or the winter, you can rest assured knowing this system will have you covered. Putting the brolly up could not be simpler. Simply locate the silver pole into the hub, turn it till it's tight, erect it until the button clicks, and then proceed to thread the two ribs around the outer of the brolly, the two shorter of the storm poles, and obviously left with a decision as to whether have the front on or not. In this case, we've not, so we've just put the two long storm poles at an angle and proceeded to peg it out. If you want to go the whole hog, clip the ground sheet in the four location points around the brolly, and then proceed to zip the front on. There's holes in the material in which to thread the two longer storm poles that will give you the typical HQ brolly shape. Thread those in and then proceed to peg the brolly in a strategic manner all the way around. And you've got a system that will keep you dry, happy and comfortable no matter what the weather.